Hello, in this video I'm going to show you how to find the pottery pail list so that if you need to see all of the pottery pails in one place and what the pottery pail readings were, you can find them all at once. So this is the 2017 version of the Madaba Plains Project FileMaker database. This is an older version and we currently have the 2020 version, which will soon update all of the iPads for the HESPAN project, and soon, hopefully soon. So this is the way you do that. If you'll notice, I am starting at the very first page, which is where we can see all the locust sheets. As you know, at the top where it says Earth Locust, there are arrows. Those arrows allow you to press the button and to see all of the loci that are there. You can go to the front, you can go all the way to the beginning, you can go click all the way to the end. We're going to go to the beginning, and now we're at what's called the information page. To see the pottery pails, all you need to do is tap the pottery button, which is on the left. And you can tap this pottery button at any time to get to the pottery pails. And what you see is the pottery pail tag that should resemble the same pottery pail tag that was filled out manually and attached to the pottery when it was shipped back to the lab to be studied. If we scroll, you can see it here. It says the date of the pail, the season, and the pottery pail number, diags, totals, baskets, and pubs, and that this was from the sift. Now that is for pottery pail number 4, but if I wanted to see if this particular locus had more than one pottery pail, then what we would do is we scroll down, and this is where we'd add another one, such as pail 5 or something like that. But this one, it does not. Now if I want to see other loci, that is the pottery pails to other loci, all I need to do is tap that right arrow button right next to Earth Locust. Just tap that button right there, and what you can see now is that I am now on pottery pail number 6, and I can scroll to see, nope, nothing below that, that's fine. But you can see that all the pottery reading is in the box called reading. And again, if I just tap the next one, here's pottery pail number 7, pottery pail number 8, and so on. So this shows them if you want to go through and extract the information, and you're going to do this manually. So if we go back, let's say we're going to go back to the beginning, like so. And let's suppose now I want to see all of them. This is going one at a time, but I want to see them all together. To do that, you'll see that there is a button at the bottom that says list. So I tap on the list button and it says, what kind of list do I want? I want the pottery. So now it gives me, and now you'll notice it also popped up a keyboard. We don't need the keyboard, so I'm going to just sort of get rid of the keyboard. And then it gives me the option of, do I want this to see the pottery pails for the architecture loci, the earth loci, or the installation loci? So I want to see the ones for the earth. That takes me now to a list, and here is the list that you can see here, and I can scroll through the list, and what it shows me are all of the pottery pails for each locus. Now I'm going to first sort it to make sure that they're all in order, and now I can see that they're all in order. So as I go along here, I can see pottery pail number locus 1, locus 2, locus 3, 4, 6, and now it looks like 5 isn't there. That's probably because it's some other type of locus. That means it might be an architecture locus or something like that. So as I just continue to scroll through, you can see all of the pottery pails that are earth pottery pails. Now it is also possible that there might be more than one pottery pail. That is, let's say that locus 7 not only has pottery pail number 9, but also has a pottery pail number 10. To find that out, you click the all pottery pails to see, and this will show you pottery pail, any additional pottery pails that might have been under the locus. So this list only shows them by locus, and it'll only show the very first one of the locus. If you want to see all the additional ones, you press the all right there. Now you should also see where it says additional pottery pails, it will list them for you, and at this point I don't see any on this. It doesn't look like this iPad has any that had more than one pottery pail per locus, so we weren't pulling out a lot of pottery. Now if you want to look at this any particular pottery pail up close and personal, over on the right hand there's a button that says arrow, says details. If I tap the details, it's going to take me back to the locus number 7, tap the pottery pail, and here is that pottery pail tag as it would have been filled out. So again, you tap the list button, select pottery, like so, select earth or architecture installation, and then now you have a nice list of all of the pottery pails that are for this square. You can see them, they're all listed there, and it shows the locus, the square, the locus information, the pottery pail number, and so on. So if you have any further questions, just don't hesitate to send me an email and I'll gladly help you at bates@andrews.edu. Once you want to return, just hit the return button, decide where you want to go. In this case, you want to go to the earth locus, and we are back where we started.